revealed for the vindication of our own concept and repudiation of that thing to be fallacious, fictional and irrelevant. So, taking this into consideration, without inviting the public, because between the scholars, they will ask only reasonable questions. The questions are of several types, and there are some special type of questions. For example, if somebody thinking that they must ask all questions, if somebody asks, what is the total count of the hairs in your head? If somebody asks, that we can answer with a staunch belief that they will not come for counting. Then Sarvajna Bhatta, a great erudite scholar, he passed through the street. Everybody was just appraising him, extolling him to such a very high level that he is Sarvajna Bhatta, he is Sarvajna Bhatta. The whole Srirangam was stunned by his arrival and everybody was very much appreciating his knowledge with great reverence and deference. At that time, Parashara Bhatta, he was a small kid, he was just playing with his friends in the street. And he just asked Sarvajna Bhatta himself, who was inside the particular procession, he himself approached impudently and he just asked, what is your name? Sarvajna Bhatta. Sarvam Janatiti Sarvajna. As I know everything, I am known as Sarvajna. Suddenly, he took a handful of sand and he asked, how much sand is there inside? Sarvajna Bhatta was blinking. Then he just asked the same question, he reciprocated. Can you answer? Yes, it is a handful. You could not say it and why you are Sarvajna? So, that type of questions which lead to practical decisions, practical applications and result in such a venture which totally leads to some application for the welfare of the universe. These things are the questions which really comes from the spirit. And that which comes from intellect is for self-knowledge, improving one's own knowledge, and also something appreciation of the person also. For appreciation of the person also, and for knowing one's own self also, the question is coming from intellect. But mind is a monkey which will put all questions. So, that is why I selected wisdom. Somebody told that somebody is from the geology and somebody is from oceanography. What we can put? That is what I told D.K. Virajan. You see, how we can commonly unify all these varieties? Just as Punjabi, Sindhi, Gujarati, how we can unify Indian? So several faculties are there and several people are representing their own disciplines. So I found it very much apt and appropriate to put the topic as wisdom. So what is wisdom? Sa vidya ya vimuktaye. What is vidya? What is jnana? Wisdom is something which relieves the person from the murky clutches of anudaya, nescience, viparyaya, misapprehension, samshaya, suspicion, vismriti, oblivion, vipralipsa, deception. So that which makes the person trouble-free from the murky entanglements of knowledge, that which gives you the exact presentation of something accurate and immaculate, that is what we call wisdom. That may be in any faculty. Even it may be starting with a construction science towards the cosmology. How this house has been built is also a question. How this cosmos has been constructed is also a question. Both deal with the Nirmana Shastra. One is Jagan Nirmana and second is Gehan Nirmana. So there are different types of questions. So in the pursuit of knowledge, several people are approaching several boards. Samjnanam, prajnanam, vijnanam, that has been stated in the Vedas. That type of knowledge which makes the person to be inquisitive of one's own origin, nature and other connected things, that is known as samjnana. There are three types of entities: bhokta, bhogyam, preritarancha matva, jushtastatastena amritatvameti, so says the Veda. The sentient, insentient and super sentient, there are three types of entities. That type of knowledge that tempts the person to the exploration of sentient, that is Atma Vichara, that is known as Samjnana. Vijnana is a study of matter. And Prajnana is the Vishesha Jnana which deals with the exploration of Brahman. Yasya matam, tasya matam, மதம் யஸ்ய ந வேத சஹ அவிஜ்ஞாதம் விஜானதாம் விஜ்ஞாதம் அவிஜானதாம். இஃப் எ பர்சன் சேஸ் தட் ஹி ஹஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் பிரம்மன், ஹி ஹஸ் நாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் இட். இஃப் த பர்சன் கேன் சே தட் ஹி ஹஸ் நாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட், தென் ஹி ஹஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட். சோ பிரம்மன் இஸ் சச் எ டிஃபரண்ட் டைப் ஆஃப் என்டிட்டி which is known to the persons who can claim that it is not being known, and which is not known to the persons who claim that they are known. So it is far beyond the captivation of one's own mind and its explorations. So that is what we call prajnana. If you want to know what are the things around us, that is vijnana. Each and everything, what is it, what is the nature, what is the use of it, that is vijnana. If you go for research of one's own self, who am I, that is some jnana. Then if you want to know the person who has made the things around you and also you, that is known as prajnana. There are three types of jnanas. What is the connection, where is the meeting point between vijnana and prajnana? We have lot of opinions in which people used to say whatever the Germans, they have now, they have understood and they are now practically implementing in various fields of science. Everything has been written in our shastras and they have stolen it before so many centuries, and they are just keeping it and doing things. This is what we hear from lot of people. See, the Germans, they have no doubt Max Muller, E.B. Cowell, A.B. Keith, A. McDonald, Professor Boothling, then Monier Williams, lot of scholars, Theodore Goldstucker, Schopenhauer, there are lot of people who have translated and who have done lot of books, like Sacred Books of the East, Bibliotheca Indica, Bibliotheca Britannica, lot of books they have done here through Royal Asiatic Society of Bengal and the various other sources. But there is no clear evidence that they have done something from this. You see, great people, they think alike. If a person in Australia, if he is practicing truth, we cannot say that he has stolen Thirukkural and he is practicing it. There are some universal visions which is revealed to one person through one path and revealed to a different person by a different mode of approach. So our knowledge remains unique in the way of revealing something which is not revealed to modern science. For example, the transmigration. That is the science eschatology. When we plan to talk something about the life after death, today I told that it is was to conduct a separate seminar on that after soon this Pattabhishekam and the other North India tours are over. I have given the topic interval to deal specially with, exclusively with eschatology, the life after death. These things, eschatology, ontology, these types of some sciences which deals with something happened before creation and something is going to happen after dissolution, it is far beyond the reach of modern science. That we have to use the spiritual science for that. Even in aeronautics and other things, these